Alright, well, the whole idea of tonight, is to assume that you don't know anything about playing music at all. Right, just a thing. But what we're going to do is, first thing, you need finger in the air, chord in your hand. Now, so the whole thing is, your note is going to come off the end of that finger. You can add more later on if you want to. You can add, sometimes you can add less if you want later on. That's another story altogether. One finger's good. And then you can add more. Use the ball of your finger across those strings. So the same spot where the instrument meets the neck. Strumming in there, strumming in there, up. We're going to call that the upstroke. It won't take long to get used to it, because what we'll do now is we'll go into the down one. Down, two. We'll get past this fairly quickly. This is just building into being able to do a simple little strum. Now your upstroke. Spending just some basic time. Good. And down. We'll move through this fairly quickly. And up, down, good. And up, good, straight down, down, and up, down, and up, down, and up. So don't move your hand much. You can even rest it on the instrument if you want to, but try and keep the main words happening just in that finger flick that I showed you at the start there. So you can pick up the pace a little bit, and then down, up, down. Couple of things about the strings, keeps going. That's another thing about this little thing too. We'll try and do everything as we can without stopping the play. We'll just keep going through, because then you get enough time. It's run. Okay, a little bit of housekeeping. I call the top string the closest to my top, the bottom string the closest to my feet. Oh, the other thing you might want to know as well is these lines across the ukulele, they're called frets. When I say, take your ring finger, put it on the bottom string, just behind the third line, the third fret there. So it's just on the other side of that line there. Yep.
The third one.
Yeah, good. The other third one. Right, so there's the first chord we're going to do tonight. It's a C. So, that's your home chord, so like any time you're playing a song in the key of C, there's your C. You could actually play probably most songs just using one chord if you really wanted. There's pretty much four main chords that get used in songs. Keep this rhythm going while I'm talking you down, up, down, up, down, up. The thing is as well, to keep the sound of your up and down about the same volume as each other, because you want to hear the up. I think a lot of people, once they get the downstroke, think, yeah, well, that'll do, but you miss the whole sound. So it's really important you get that ball of your finger up there, tap, 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 tap. And I will be a bit of a nagging bugger about this. Okay, so you've got that first chord, that's your C chord. We'll give you the second chord. Second chord from where you are now. Take your middle finger, put it on the top string behind the second fret. Take the other one off. So you've just got your middle finger there, and it's up one, two from the top there on the top string. You keep that pattern going, and you use the middle finger so that it's easy to change back and forth. Very good idea to use the fingers I'm suggesting, so that means that when you use your middle finger there, because that way when you move around the chords, if you've got your fingers right, it's really, really easy. It's like a ballet. And otherwise, so for the next one, down, up, down, you keep that finger there, don't move it. And you take your index finger, put it on the third string down from the top, on the first fret, so you get that. So you got that one you want where you were. So you go back to where you were on that A minor. So middle finger on the top string. Middle finger, yep.
two frets in, and then you put this finger down on the third string on the first fret. That's it, you've got it.
Yeah.
Yep, that's good. You've got it. So it's just those.
There's four chords, being the C, the A minor, the F, and the G. Once you've got the box set, you can play pretty much anything.
Okay, so back to the first one again. Bottom string. Just want to get you moving nice and quickly, that's good. Down, up, down. And the middle finger on the top. Yeah? That's it. You got it? Yeah, you're right, that's good. And you take your index finger and you put it on that first fret there. Cool. Okay, so now we know where that one is. We're going to go back to the previous one. So keep your middle finger there, take your index finger off. You're up there on the third fret, yeah, you got it, good. So there's the first one. To the second one. The A minor, middle finger, top string. Middle finger on the top string, just like we did 30 seconds ago. Yeah, that's it. Good one. Put your middle finger on the top string behind the second fret. Good. Now back to the first one again. So, bottom string, middle finger, the A minor. Yeah, but make sure that you've actually got one finger doing it, because otherwise you're just going to graze your knuckles. And that's never a good look at having a cup of tea down on the front of the street, I tell you. How'd you get those knuckles? Oh, I'm playing ukulele. Yeah, I don't believe you. So, now we've got this chord here. Keep the index finger where it is. Yep. Move your middle finger across to the second string. So you get that? Yep. Okay. Now, bring your ring finger down on the bottom string so you get the triangle there. That's good. That was pretty good. So it's that little triangle straight there for the G7. Yep. Once we get this up and running in the circle, it's dead easy. Okay, good now. So going around the circle, we're going to go straight to the first one. That's really, really easy because remember it was the bottom string and your fingers already lined up. So when you just take the other two off and slide down, you're back on that C chord again, right? Good. With that fourth finger, definitely the fourth finger is in spite of Gray's knuckles there. So middle finger on the top string for each one. That's good, we'll start to move it down. Now your index finger down. Once we get these up in a circle, I'll put a song on it to be where all the flowers go on. It's practice of going around the chords. So, next one, the G. Well, it's actually a G7. Remember that one, the triangle one? Yep, there you got it. So, middle finger there, that one there, and that on that bottom string is that fourth finger behind the second line. Yep, you got it. That's it. That's like the only four that we're going to learn. So, that was the fourth. So, now back to the first one. Back on the second one now. We've changed again.
Soldiers everyone. Oh, wow. When will they ever learn? When will they ever learn? Look, I think too much on the telly lately. Nice and even, it's good. Where have all the soldiers gone? Long time passing. Where have all the soldiers gone? Long time ago. Where have all the soldiers gone? Gone to break us everyone. When will they ever learn? When will they ever learn? And the last one.
I think that's enough for you to learn for one night. That'll keep you out of trouble for a little while. If you want to know any more about this sort of stuff as well, you're very welcome to come down here any other Wednesday night too, because most of the people floating around are actually members of the Adelaide Ukulele Appreciation Society. They're all very unapproachable. Okay? Oh, they may be.